Les Szarka here with some smart financial moves. Mm-hmm. If you're deciding to work a little bit later in life or perhaps consider a part-time job, we need to make some right decisions here.
I'm still thinking about this whole sweating thing you got. This
you're not a,
I'm a sweater. Sorry, right? You're looking at him a whole new way, huh?
I like to run.
It's kind of creepy. But
sweat it all out, yeah.
He does shower before he comes to work.
Let's talk about this. I mean, a lot of folks who are near the age of, you know, 55, 60, 65, they're on the fence. What should I do to really get the most bang for my buck? How much longer should I work? Or should I perhaps take a part-time job? We got quite a dilemma.
What we've seen over the last number of years is this phenomenon where a lot of folks, especially after the Great Recession, were let go. So the good news was, well, hey, you still have your job. The bad news is the work didn't decrease and you have to work twice as hard. So they've been under a lot of stress now for 8 years. And so I'm running into quite a number of folks that are, let's say, in their late 50s, early 60s, that are just completely burned out. And it's like, I want to get out of the rat race. Just, you know, let me retire or do something.
Not only can it be a rat race, and you're kind of sick of it, but then for some people it can be a lot of stress is not good on their health. So they're getting a little bit older. And now they have a lot of pressure, a lot of stress, and a lot of times hazardous situations that they're working under that might not be good for them in their health either. They're getting older.
Exactly.
It's not like when they were 20 and they went into the business of being a carpenter or whatever it may be.
The problem is that a lot of these folks aren't in a position where they can retire financially. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they're not quite there yet. They need to work a few more years, and they're struggling with this. I don't want to go to work. So a lot of times the solution is just do something part-time. Get out of the rat race. Mm-hmm. You don't have to make that $50,000, $60,000, $70,000. Go find something that'll pay you maybe $15,000 or $20,000 that's a lot less stress. And maybe it's even something that you enjoy doing, working on a golf course or something like that. So for a lot of times that's the solution. The thing you have to be careful of, though, is how that coordinates. You know, you mentioned a little bit earlier off the air about benefits.
Yeah,
you know, so if you're not 65, you're not eligible for Medicare yet, then you have to worry about health insurance. If you are going to make over roughly $14,000 and you plan on taking your Social Security, you got to be careful because it'll reduce your Social Security benefits. Mm. So you really don't want to take Social Security if you're making more than that. So you do have to coordinate everything together. And at the end of the day, you want to work the numbers backwards and say, well, can I actually do this? Is this feasible where I find this blend, if you will, of I can get out of the rat race, but I can still maintain the standard of living that I would like to have in retirement? Because most folks don't want to get out of the rat race and they have to take a substantial drop.
What's the number one mistake people make when they're considering whether or not to continue working, go part-time, you know, they're right at age 62. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What's the number one mistake you see people making?
They pull the trigger too early. And they really can't afford to do it. And so they find out years later that, you know, I wish I really would have worked a few more years and put myself on a little bit better footing financially to do it. And so you really do want to be careful. You know, this is not
because once you make the choice and you say I'm out,
you retire,
you better
you leave,
be right.
They throw you the party and give you the watch and then it's hard to come back.
Exactly.
You better get it right, Les.
Exactly. You know, so you know, you do want to make sure you're talking to somebody that can crunch the numbers and make sure that you can afford to do this. But I would encourage folks that if you're at that point where I just have to get out, look at some of the alternatives. And a lot of times the answer's right in front of you. It's just not obvious sometimes.
Yeah.
And I said someone in the other day and they were really, really stressed. They had to get out. And I got the biggest hug I've gotten probably a number of years because it was like, I feel so much better now that it's a solution.
Yes.
It's not something where I have to dread going in for the next.
Any secrets on good part-time gigs that people are seeming to cash in on now? You mentioned the golf course, perhaps a Walmart, a major box store.
Walmart. I've had some utility guys that work for the electric companies now with all the hurricanes going on, and they're hiring these guys, you know, for the next 2 months, 3 months. And that's a pretty decent gig.
Yeah. We were hearing years ago, you know, when the markets tanked and things were really getting bad and a lot of companies were kind of forcing people to retire back after the 08 and all that stuff was happening, that a lot of the seniors and people who wanted to go part-time couldn't, and then they're competing for jobs with college students because there weren't a lot of part-time jobs available. Are you seeing that different now in 2017?
Yeah, definitely. There are definitely more employment opportunities. And the other thing, keep in mind from an employer's perspective, a lot of these folks that are a little bit older now, especially if you're over 65 and on Medicare and looking to do something part-time, you're very attractive to an employer because you don't have to pay benefits. The employer doesn't have to pay benefits because you're already off that dole. So don't, you know, I hear this a lot where, you know, I'm not going to be really attractive to an employer. Mm-hmm. It's like, no. you're very attractive. Yeah. You come in with a lot of experience and knowledge,
sure.
and the benefits are a lot lower.
And probably, yeah, consulting, great employee.
Lots of consulting gigs out there. If you have questions, and we know you do because we certainly do, just simply contact us on our website, fox8.com. You can also reach out to Les Szarka there, 440-779-1430. Great advice, as
Perfect.
Always. Thank you, Les.
So when we retire, he's going to work on the golf course, and I am going to work in the ice cream shop.